Good morning students, welcome to our online video class of chemistry. We had completed second chapter solution. In this video we will do some problems. Question is, calculate the mass percent of benzene C6H6 and carbon tetrachloride CCl4. If 22 gram of benzene is dissolved in 122 gram of carbon tetrachloride, we have to calculate the mass percentage of benzene. Mass percentage is equal to mass of the solute divided by mass of the solution into 100. Then mass of benzene equal 22 gram, which is given in the question. Then mass of carbon tetrachloride, which is equal 122 gram. This also given in the question. Then mass percentage of benzene equals mass of solute. Here the solute is benzene. Then 22 gram divided by mass of solution. Mass of solution equals total or sum of mass of solute plus mass of solvent. That is 22 gram plus 122 gram into 100, which is equal 15.28%. Then mass of carbon tetrachloride equals 100 minus 15.28, which is equal 84.72%. Calculate the mole fraction of benzene in a solution containing 30% by mass of it in carbon tetrachloride. Here we have to calculate the mole fraction of benzene. Let us start with the 100 gram of the solution, in which mass of benzene, which is given, that is 30 gram. Then mass of carbon tetrachloride, 100 minus 30, which is equal 70 gram. What is mole fraction? Mole fraction is the ratio of number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of all the components.
C6H6, that is benzene.
Molar mass of benzene.
6 into atomic mass of carbon plus 6 into atomic mass of hydrogen, that is 1.
Plus 6 into atomic mass of hydrogen, that is 1.
Gram per
which
mole,
which is equal 78 gram mole inverse. Then number of moles of benzene, which is equal mass by molar mass. Mass of benzene, which is 30 gram, divided by molar mass. Molar mass of benzene is 78 gram per mole. On substituting these values, we get the value of mole fraction of benzene as 0.385 mole.
Then molar mass of carbon tetrachloride, which is equal 12 plus 4 into atomic mass of chlorine, that is 35.5, which is equal 154 gram per mole. Then number of moles of carbon tetrachloride equal its mass, that is 70 gram, divided by molar mass, that is 154 gram per mole. On dividing this, we get 0.454 moles. Then mole fraction of benzene, which is equal number of moles of particular component, that is benzene, divided by total number of moles of all the components. that is NC6H6 plus NCCl4, which is equal 0.385 mol divided by 0.385 plus 0.454. On dividing this, we get 0.459. This is the mole fraction of benzene.
The next problem is calculate molality, molarity and mole fraction of potassium iodide. If the density of 20% aqueous potassium iodide solution is 1.202 gram per milliliter. Step 1, calculation of molality of the solution. Weight of potassium iodide in 100 gram of the solution equal 20 gram. Then weight of water in the solution equals 100 minus 20 equal 80 gram or 0.08 kilogram. Then molar mass of potassium iodide equal atomic mass of potassium, that is 39, plus atomic mass of iodine, that is 127, equals 166 gram mole inverse. Then molality of the solution can be calculated using the equation molality equals number of gram moles of potassium iodide divided by mass of water in kilogram. Then number of gram moles of potassium iodide equal 20, the mass divided by its molar mass, that is number of gram moles of potassium iodide, equals 20 gram divided by 166 gram mole inverse divided by mass of water in kilogram, that is 0.08 kilogram, which is equals 1.506 mole kilogram inverse or 1.506 m, where this unit of molality is mole per kg. This step is calculation of molarity of the solution. Weight of solution equal 100 gram. Then density of the solution equals 1.202 gram milliliter inverse. Here density is given in the question. Then volume of the solution equals weight of the solution divided by density. Weight of the solution equal 100 gram divided by density. 1.202 gram per milliliter equals 83.19 milliliter. Then molarity of the solution. We have to calculate the molarity. And the equation for calculating molarity equals number of gram moles of potassium iodide divided by volume of solution in liters. Then we have to convert this 83.19 milliliter into liter. We know that 1 liter equal 1000 milliliter. Then to convert milliliter into liter, we have to multiply this quantity with the 10 to the power of minus 3. Then we get 0.083 liter. Molarity of the solution equal number of gram moles of potassium iodide divided by volume of solution in liters. Number of gram moles of Ki equal its mass divided by molar mass, that is 20 gram divided by 166 gram per mole, all divided by volume of solution in liter, that is 0.083 liter. On substituting these values, we get 1.45 mole liter inverse, that is unit of molarity. Third step is calculation of mole fraction. Number of moles of potassium iodide equal mass of
Ki divided by molar mass of Ki, which is equal 20 gram divided by 166 gram mole inverse equals 0.12 mole. Then number of moles of water equals mass of H2O divided by molar mass of H2O, that is 80 divided by 18 gram per mole. On dividing this we get 4.44 mole. Then XKI, that is mole fraction of potassium iodide, equal number of moles of particular component, that is number of moles of Ki divided by total number of moles of all the components, that is NKI plus NH2O, which is equal 0.12 mole divided by 0.12 plus 4.44 mole, which is equals 0.0263. This is the mole fraction of potassium iodide. H2S, a toxic gas with rotten egg smell, is used for the qualitative analysis. If the solubility of H2S in water at HTP is 0.19 m, calculate Henry's law. M indicates molality. Calculation of mole fraction of H2S 0.19 m of the gas means that 0.195 moles of it is dissolved in 1000 gram of water. Then number of moles of H2O in 1000 gram equals 1000 divided by its molar mass, that is 18 gram mole inverse, which is equal 55.55 mole. Then mole fraction of H2S equals XH2S equals NH2S divided by NH2S plus NH2O. Number of moles of hydrogen sulfide equals 0.195 mole, which is given in the question, divided by 0.195 plus number of moles of water, that is 55.55 mole, equals 0.0035. Then Henry's constant, H2S equal partial pressure of H2S divided by KH for H2S. KH is Henry's constant. It is different for different gases. Then we know that the partial pressure equals KH into mole fraction. According to Henry's law, the partial pressure of the gas is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Then from this equation, H equals P by K. Then from this equation, we can calculate KH. KH equal partial pressure of H2S divided by mole fraction of H2S. That is 0.987 bar divided by 0.0035, which is equal to 282 bar. Calculate the osmotic pressure in pascals exerted by a solution prepared by dissolving 1.0 gram of a polymer of molar mass 1,85,000 in 450 ml of solution at 37 degree Celsius. Here we have to calculate the osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure pi equals CRT or WB into RT divided by MB into V, where WB is the mass of solute and MB is the molar mass of solute. R is gas constant and T is temperature and V is the volume of the solution. Then mass of polymer is given in the question, that is 1.0 gram. Then molar mass of polymer is also given, 185,000 gram mole inverse. Then volume of the solution is also given in the question, that is 450 milliliter. We have to convert it into liter. 450 milliliter equal 450 into 10 to the power of minus 3 liter. It is equal 0.450 liter. Temperature. Temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. We have to convert into Kelvin scale. Then 37 plus 273 equal 3110 Kelvin. Solution constant R equal 8.314 into 10 to the power of 3 Pascal liter Kelvin inverse mole inverse. Then pi, osmotic pressure pi equals, substitute this value in equation number 1, WB, that is mass of solutical 1.0 gram into gas constant 8.314 into 10 to the power of 3 into temperature 3110 divided by molar mass of the solute. Molar mass of polymer is given 185,000 into volume of the solution, which is 0.450 liter. On dividing this, we get 30.96 Pascal. This is the osmotic pressure.